At the AFC East with the Patriots. Bucky, we're going to get to your best pick, your most surprising pick, give your grade as well. Look at that chart. Not a lot of names on it, not a lot to choose from.
But you don't even worry about that with the Patriots.
You
don't have to worry about that because when you're looking at the draft grade for the Patriots, you're thinking about Brandon Cooks and Coney Ealy, guys that they traded for. So because of that, I thought they did a pretty good job. But the guy that I'm fascinated by that they took, how about Derek Rivers from Youngstown State? This is another guy that they can throw into the mix as a pass rusher. Outstanding instincts, awareness.
He kind of looks like a Patriots lineman,
speed,
right?
He just has that. Long, rangy, does a good job of using his hands. He should be another productive player. But if not, they already got him protected because they have Coney Ealy there. They took.
Again, Elliot, we've seen time and time again that this is a team that doesn't have to use the draft to find playmakers, or they'll find guys in ways you didn't expect to.
Well, I like what they did here. But you mentioned Coney Ealy. I like the fact that they used a pick to trade to get Coney Ealy because he's going to help them win right now. So I like both things. You get a guy for the future that can get in a rotation, and you get a guy that can play right now.
Yeah, the draft is part of their overall strategy to stock this team with players, but that doesn't mean there aren't surprises. And for you, who was that?
The biggest surprise to me was Connor McDermott at the bottom of the draft. And the reason I say it's a huge surprise, he had a tough time staying with elite edge rushers in college. And so where does he fit in? I know it's the end of the draft, sixth-round pick. You're not really counting on these guys to play, but what if he does have to play? We've seen Nate Solder get hurt. We've seen some of the other guys get hurt. We have to force a guy in. I just don't know if he's athletic or skilled enough to man that outside.
It is just interesting, though, because Elliot said maybe some teams overvalue draft picks, and that's never what we hear. It's always the opposite. But for them, the proof is in the pudding. This team somehow, some way, almost no matter how they draft and how they get players, is able to win football games and championships.
You bet. Well, they develop young players, but they also know where they are as a group right now. And that's what I love about Bill Belichick, his approach. They get out a year early on a guy as opposed to a year late. I like the fact that they went and got Mike Gillisley. You know, those kind of little moves. Last year, no one really cared when they got Chris Hogan except for the Bills Mafia because they loved that guy. How much did he help them in the postseason run? So, Bucky, I know it's arguable for me to say that sometimes draft picks are overvalued, but I do feel that way because, let's be honest, half these guys, more than half of these guys taking the draft are not going to pan out to what fans hope they'll be.
But you still have to give them a grade, Bucky. How do you assess?
Well, just for the draft itself, I'll give them a C. I mean, obviously, if we were including Brandon Cooks and Coney Ealy in the process, it would be an A. But just for the guys that they selected, I'll give them a C. No notable stars, but guys that will come in and be backups or key contributors down the line.
Moving to the New York Jets as we stay in the AFC East. And as you look at this list of players right here, you may notice a lot of back-end help as well. This is a team that later on in the draft picked up some guys on the back end too. But right off the top, Jamal Adams, you see they pick him at safety in the first round. And Bucky, is there any question that this is the best pick the Jets made?
This is the best pick. I think he may have been the best player in this draft class when it comes to putting everything together. The playing talent that he has on the field, the leadership ability that he's going to bring to the locker room, his intensity, his intelligence, everything that he brings is what the Jets desperately needed. He is going to help change the culture with that team. I love this pick because he is a baller, and we're going to see very soon he's going to light up Broadway.
But maybe it is a culture change that they need more than just the guys on the field because there were so many holes for them to plug. You look at a defense that allowed a 98.5 passer rating against last year, almost the worst in the league, about 30th when it all shakes out. So many places they need to get help.
Yeah, and when we show a Tyrod Taylor to Goodwin deep ball to show that pretty much relays exactly what you were saying. You know, look, I love this pick for the Bears. Oh, wait, that's right. The Bears didn't take him, passed on him, got Trubisky instead, which I didn't like, which meant that he fell into the Jets' hands. Doesn't this just feel like a couple of years ago when they got Leonard Williams? Same kind of deal, safe pick. What could you not like about this? He instantly makes them better.
Bucky, again, though, I go back to the fact that four DBs taken for this team when you look at every single round. That's not where a lot of people project the Jets to go.
No, a lot of people didn't predict that, but I like the fact that they took another DB, which is a surprise, Marcus May, the safety to pair up with Jamal Adams. What I will say about Marcus May, and talking to Quincy Wilson and T's Table when they came into the building, they talked about this guy was the leader in the back end. So now they have two guys with outstanding leadership ability and outstanding talent in the safety. I'm a big believer in an old school philosophy. You build your defense strong right down the middle. They now have two safeties in the middle of the field that can control it. They can act as traffic cops while also acting as enforcers. That is a way you build a very, very good and solid secondary.
But when you take those guys early, you expect them to start or be on the field a lot. Can they both get on the field this
early?
Oh,
yeah, I think so. I think the alert is on Calvin Pryor. I think Calvin Pryor has probably lost his job. Those two guys will be on the field right away. They'll control it. And because they should be able to control it so well, I'm going to give them an A. I like what the New York Jets were able to do.
Circle that, Elliot. Make sure to keep tabs.
Yeah, I mean, so many teams playing dime packages, six defensive backs now. You get those guys on the field. The only thing I was surprised at was the safety, wide receiver order they went in the draft. I mean, this was a team that could have, you know, needs everywhere. I was a little surprised at that. But other than that, I thought they had a good draft.
Moving on to the Buffalo Bills, and notwithstanding the changes in the front office that happened after this draft was all said and done, here is how things shook out for them in the earlier rounds. Tre'davious White in the first, Zay Jones in the second. Nathan Peterman, a quarterback in the fifth.
Like that one,
we'll
man.
Discuss that one in a second. But who's your favorite on this list, Buck?
You know, this is tough for me because Buffalo Bills had a very nice draft, and a couple of my buddies in there working in the scouting offices lost their jobs after that. And Sean McDermott did a great job of kind of putting together the squad. The guy that I like the most will be Tre'davious White. Tre'davious White, as a cornerback, is everything that you look for. He's solid and dependable. He is a guy that is going to play and do it to the letter that the coach wants. Terrific discipline, outstanding with the details, nice technique, feisty and competitive. I think he's just a solid overall player. I know they lost Stephon Gilmore, but this is a guy that reminds me so much of Gilmore. He's going to come in and really fill that void.
But you do look at last year, yards per game in the passing game allowed. They were sixth best, only 223.9 when it's all said and done. Sometimes you go to like a tremendous area of need. Sometimes you shore up what is already a strength, Elliot.
Yeah, and again, it depends on how the chips fall. You know, Bucky kind of alluded to it. Strange timing. I know that it was the end of the scouting season with the moves that were made in Buffalo. The ironic thing is I thought they had a pretty good draft. As far as the Gilmore comparison, Gilmore's a good player, but there were times that he had some peaks and valleys, you know? So I'm with Bucky on this. I really like the pick of White, big time.
I kind of gave it away earlier. I mentioned Nathan Peterman. He is the surprise pick for you, Bucky. Certainly a guy that at Pitt, some people thought his game could translate the best to the pro game out of all the quarterbacks.
Well, I mean, I think some of those people that have made the comparisons to Kirk Cousins and the like the fact that he played in a pro-style offense, and when you do the evaluation, it's easy to see how his game could go to Sundays. I worry about his ability to make big throws in inclement conditions. Yeah, I know he played in Pittsburgh, but this is not a big, strong arm pass. He's a guy that does it more on timing and anticipation. In Buffalo, where you have to throw against those cutting winds, you got to have a big arm. And I know he's not as talented as Cardale Jones. We'll see if he can beat Cardale Jones out as the number two.
You asked us to grade the draft. And one of the things that made the draft really interesting were teams overpaying for quarterbacks. That's why I loved this pick. Mm. Because Buffalo didn't necessarily need him. They didn't have to overpay. They took him in the fifth round. And they also took him at such a low round that I don't think Tyrod Taylor is going to be sitting there staring over his shoulder at a fifth round pick. So I love it. If Tyrod Taylor were to go down, though, you mentioned his work in a pro-style offense. Mm-hmm. Perhaps he could step in and maybe win a game or two for them in November or December.
Is it at all weird to give a grade to a draft where you saw the GM head out the door as soon as it was all said
and done? Yeah, it's weird to me. It's weird to me, and it's weird that so many people are giving credit to Sean McDermott. Maybe he did a good job, I mean, but I just think it's unusual for a coach to be able to come in and manipulate the draft board and do all the things that were necessary. There were a team of people behind him that did that, and some of those guys lost their jobs. I give them a B for their efforts. It's a solid overall draft. I think this is a team that is getting back on track. They did some really good things on draft day. It's just weird to see everyone ushered out the door right after draft when it was a really solid draft based on first glance.
Yeah, some friction apparently with some of those picks, though, may have led to that ouster. But we'll continue the conversation in Miami, the final team in the AFC East that we're grading today. And Charles Harris, outside linebacker help in the first round. Bucky, you go down the rest of their board as well. Isaac Asiata, Isaiah Ford later on. Who's your favorite?
Charles Harris. Charles Harris is what they needed off the edge. Cam Wake is lonely out there. He's doing everything by himself. He's the only pass rusher. And at 35 years old, you need to find someone that can be a compliment. Everyone needs a playmate. Charles Harris is the perfect playmate for him. Quick, elusive, has a nice spin move to get inside. He is going to be a guy that quickly becomes a double-digit sack artist in Miami.
Who is a surprise that might contribute right now?
I'm a little surprised. Cordre Tankersley from Clemson going in the third round to the Dolphins. Just a little bit of surprise. This is a player who has the physical tools to be a really good player. He's tall. He's long. He can run a little bit. His biggest issue is he panics a little bit when the ball is in the air, and it can be a little handsy. He likes to grab a little bit. He will have to kind of learn or unlearn some of those bad habits that he picked up at Clemson, because if he does that, he can be a pretty solid player. They have big expectations and high hopes for him. Let's see if he can live up to those.
Yeah, certainly it's going to be interesting to see if this is a team that's capable of returning to the postseason. Can this draft help them, given the grade you're about to give?
Yeah, I'm going to give them a B+. This is a really solid draft. I think they did some really good things. I like Raekwon McMillan coming in at inside linebacker. They're now solid at the second level. They fortified their front line with Charles Harris. This is a team that is ready to compete. It all hinges on the quarterback. Let's see if Ryan Tannehill can continue to live up to the flashes that we've seen.
And I agree with all that. I think they got several guys that can contribute right now, just like the Falcons did last year. Not all stars, just guys that can come in and give you something. I think the Dolphins had a heck of a draft.
Well, that is where the value in the draft is, and that does wrap up the AFC East.